Yo, what's up, y'all? How y'all doing? Welcome back to another video. I'm your boy, Jay Bird, aka Mr. Cool Guy. And with this video, we're reviewing another album by Ludacris. This is his eighth album, recent album that came out 8 years ago, and it was 2015. And this album is called Lunaversal. This is the deluxe edition of Lunaversal. And it got about three singles off the album, such as Good Lovin', Come and See Me, Grass is Always Greener. And I gotta say, this is a dope album that Ludacris did when it was the year 2015. And it got about 18 tracks on the album. And we're gonna review all of them, starting with track one, Lunaversal intro. Here we go, y'all.
Mic check. 1, 2. I'm just gonna get right to it. Luna! Ain't nobody talking with me when they try to get delivered from murdering a rapper and killing beats. Nigga, take my cinematic, making everybody try to got me busted like a fully automatic to the heat. Nigga, we can battle in the Phantom and the Senate, the Roma in Minnesota or the Arizona streets. Nigga, we can take in all these offensive lines. I snap back at the quarterback. Don't push that fuck, boy, say my name. Anybody coming at me, know I never back down. Killing the rappers, my claim of fame. You lame, and my flows would expose any hoes, even on a nigga worst day. They say you're losing your mind in your mouth. Now, nigga, I'm a super, it's the first day. What you want, how you want it, you can get it on the definition of a real beat from the top side. The crowd scene, in the studio, get the yellow tape, but the talking, I'm leaving everybody outside. I'm out of my mind, getting paid, getting late, getting close, getting hoes, getting green back. You think you like everybody is a little kid, now I'm big boy, out past like three sacks. Licking all in the Cadillac with a red bone, giving me dough, my music on.
Now this intro, Lunaversal, I really feel that beat. It's got like a lot of trap in it, coming together with like Southern hip hop. And you all can tell me like what y'all like about track one, Lunaversal intro. Do y'all like the beat of it? Or do y'all like just like the creativity that Luda brought with doing that track? Please share. All right, moving on. Track two, single off the album, Grass is Always Greener. Here we go, y'all.
Yeah, did some movies and started missing this rap shit. Back to rap and started missing them movies. Left these hoes to settle down with just one shit. Get with one chick, started missing them groupies. Stopped drinking for a year and I was all sober. Next year I got drunk and did it all over. Yesterday I quit smoking and swore I had enough. Till I smelt it in the club and had to take a puff. I got rich, learned life was a bitch. Now everybody's after all of my ends. When I was broke, all love for my folks. But nowadays I'm losing all of my friends. Let the story begin. The grass is always greener on the other side. Always searching for another height. The grass is always greener on the other side. Caterpillar to a butterfly. The grass is always greener on the other side. Always searching for another height. The grass is always greener on the other side. Caterpillar to a butterfly. Six packs, was eating healthy and did away with the junk. Then I got lazy and started
I'm good. When I'm at the crib, I'm mad I'm not at the club lit. When I'm at the club, I'm mad I'm not at the crib. I used to be out partying every damn night. Now sometimes I'd rather be with my kids. I got checks, gained a lot of respect. Now everywhere I go, they holler my name. But sometimes wish that I was disguised for peace of mind over fortune and fame. Guess what I'm really saying? The grass is always greener on the other side. Always searching for another height. The grass is always greener on the other side. Caterpillar to a butterfly. The grass is always greener on the other side. Always searching for another height. The grass is always greener on the other side. Caterpillar to a butterfly.
I gotta say, track two. Grass is always green. I really feel that beat, and I really like them rhymes that Luda was spitting. And I gotta say, he did good with that track. It's a banging hit, and I really like his flow. And he never stopped at what he do, and he just keep letting people know how it is with his music that he put out. And that's what I like about Luda. He is a dope legend in the game. And this song, I'm glad it's a single off the album. And you walking something up, y'all think of track two. Is that one of y'all favorite gems? Y'all just like that Luda be coming back with fire. He just be good at what he do with spitting them dope rhymes. Please share. All right, moving on. Track three, Call Your Bluff. Here we go.
Yeah, buddy, what is it? What now? Damn, man, fuck them niggas. Whoever they say they was, it don't even matter, punish. This the way we do it, fuck. The A in the building, punish whatever. They know where to find me at. They know what's up. It's strictly beef drama, whatever you want to call it. Nigga, fuck them. We ball. Yeah. Anything you want to do, I'm ready to do it. My nigga, just say so.
Just say so.
Don't say it on the record with your chest. Leave the booth and then go lay low.
Yeah, guys, I'm going home.
Hiding behind your security detail. I got like a female. I done sold over 20 million records. I could really give a fuck about retail.
History's been made.
Now back to the base. Back to Adidas with the fat lace. Back to the act where I'm writing to the track. And the jacket is straight, nigga, no chase. AJ ain't nothing but another looter rapping like he just turned 24.
Happy birthday.
Any rapper wanna forget who I am? Every now and then I see him, I gotta let him know. No, must I remind you? You rap like something behind you. Got paid, but your heart pump Kool-Aid. Cover girl makeup, shit assigned you. But it's never too late. 15 years, nigga, never too great. 4 years off getting Hollywood checks, but you niggas want beef and you looking like steak. I see that liquor got you loose. When you see me, niggas say it like you said it.
In the booth,
in the booth. I make you niggas lose it.
Now track three, Call Your Bluff. I really feel the beat, and I didn't really check the song out when it came out in 2015, but the song is dope, and Luda did do good with that track, and I actually jammed to that. And you walk and tell me like what y'all like about that track. Is it tight? Y'all just feel the flow? Please share. All right, moving on, track four, Lyrical Healing. Here we go, y'all. Track four, lyrical healing. I actually feel that. And Luda did go with that beat and everything, and I really feel no rhymes, and he just cold at what he do, and I just like how he rap. You know, like, he be a beast on the track, and he be like, you know, just be spitting that heavy shit. And I just wish it could have been a whole track, but too bad the song was only a minute long, though. But you all can tell me, like, we all think a track for lyrical healing. Y'all wish that could have been a whole track, or y'all just did not like that it was just a minute long. Please share. All right, moving on. Track 5, Beast Mode. Here we go. Luda, he did snap with this track Beast Mode, and you all can tell me, like, what y'all like about that track. Y'all like that Luda snap, or y'all like that he was, like, you know, just hard on the track, you know, just like so unrated, and the beat is just dope. I really like that bass going up and down, and I really like the flow, and I wish that this could have been the single off the album, though, because Luda did snap with that track, and I actually vibe with it. And you walk to me like, we got think of track 5, Beast Mode. Is that one of y'all favorites? Please share. All right, moving on. Track 6, Virtual Skype. Here we go.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh. 911,
what's your emergency?
Yes, ma'am. I got a hard problem. Oh,
calm down, sir. It can't be that hard, okay?
No, it can't. It can't be. It is. My dick, it's been hard for over 8 hours, and it just won't go down.
Excuse me?
I took one of them Viagras for the first time.
Word?
And the first one didn't do anything, so I took another one.
Okay.
Now my shit harder than titanium, and this motherfucker, I've been knocking shit over.
Damn, I had no dick in 6 months.
It ain't like them shits come with directions. I don't know what to do, ma'am. Help.
Come on,
shit.
Pour this call to myself and confirm his address. I got you.
God, I'm gonna kill my own niggas. I ain't never listening to niggas again, man. I swear.
Calm down, sir. Help this off the way.
I can't believe these bitches set my dick up for failure.
So what happened anyway?
I invited this chick over, you know what I'm saying? This bitch I knew from a long time.
Mm-hmm.
And she said she was with a friend, and they both wanted this thing, man. Like, they both wanted to jump me off, you know what I'm saying? And
poor
then they started going to voicemail, man. I hate these bitches, man. They be doing this stupid shit.
Mm-mm. Sir, help is in the name.
right. These bitches ain't right.
Don't worry about
this
that.
This ain't right.
I don't care.
It ain't right.
Ooh, is it the one with the blow-up dolls in the front?
The one in the cut with the furry bush. It's got some furry bush. Yes, it does. I done whacked off like 3 times. I don't know what else to do.
Well, you ain't got to do that no more.
What the hell are you doing in my house?
Nigga, where the drinks at?
Oh,
when that liquor.
I meant to say Viagra, y'all, my bad, but that Skype was kind of funny, though, but sorry for pronouncing the name wrong. I meant to say Viagra, but it was all right, though. I don't really have much to say about it, though, but you all can tell me what y'all think of it in the comments below. Moving on, track 7, Get Lit. Here we go, y'all.
Get up in me. When that liquor get up in me. When that liquor get up in me. When that liquor get up in me.
I'm a motherfucking beast.
When that liquor get up in me.
Tell these niggas clear the streets.
When that liquor get up in me.
I be all up in my zone.
When that liquor get up in me.
I ain't never going home.
When that liquor get up in me.
Track 7, Get Lit. I really feel that beat, and I really like that. It's hardcore, and Luda, he did snap on this track, and I really feel his flow and his energy, and I gotta say, he's so ill when he released these type of records, and I gotta say, Track 7, that song is hardcore, and I can feel that, and you walk to me like, what y'all like about Track 7, Get Lit, please share, like, how dope that song is to y'all. Alright, moving on, Track 8. Come and see me, interlude. Here we go, y'all.
You know what? I'm so sick of your shit. Oh, what? Can I go air somewhere?
Man, listen, I need to leave.
You ain't told me shit. Fuck you.
Fuck you too. I gotta take this. Hey, some days I think I love my whip more than I love my bitch. Every time we argue, I just hop up in my whip and leave. Let's go. And my car never talk back to me. No, it just turned up and played his track for me. And my girl look intelligent, trying to wild on me. Falling to you, cause the Acura got so many miles on. And try to make her feel inferior. Here is some rubbing all on my Acura's interior. Whenever I'm with either one of my ladies, I just love her. See, cause one rides me while I'm riding the other man. I'm about to go get in some trouble, man, with the one that's like my sidekick. The other thing, she my mother, man. And I ain't with that. They both got mean bodies, but with this Maserati, see how I treat that? Pretty feet with nice paint, and they both drop the top. They both crushing their thing in the parking lot.
I pop my truck, Universal Circus, like I would have jumped out that motherfucker.
Obama inauguration
was 6:15.
Candy Coke.
I call the scene. Rolling through my hood, I call them pimping, ain't that easy. So whatever you need, little buddy, come and see me.
Say both track 8 and track 9, you know, one of them is the interlude and the other one's the main song. I gotta say track 8, Come and See Me interlude, that interlude was good. I really can feel that beat and I really like the vibe of it. And track 9, Come and See Me main title featuring Big K-R-I-T, I gotta say it's a banging hit. I really feel that beat and I really like the verses that Luda was spitting with that track, and I gotta say he did good with track 9. I like that as a single off the album. And you all can tell me like what y'all think of track 9 and track 8. Do y'all like the interlude verse, or do y'all like the main song, Come and See Me, which is the single off the album? Please share. Alright, moving on. Track 10, Good Lovin' featuring Miguel. Here we go, y'all.
I keep dwelling on the past, babe. Know what I need, yeah, yeah. I need some real good loving. Well, I'm troubled by the things that I see.
Better when I'm hearing this song and go.
I need some real good.
Okay, now track 10, Good Lovin' featuring Miguel. I really think the song is good. It's an amazing song off the album with the whole R&B coming together with hip-hop flow. And Miguel, he did good as a feature artist, even though I'm not really a fan of the guy, but he is an amazing singer. He has a unique voice and a unique talent. And I seen the video to this song. The video was excellent, and I really liked the track, and this song did get played on radios, I remember, and it's good that people gave Luda his props for doing a hip-hop slash R&B track with Miguel. And you walk to him like, we got a thing of track 10. Is y'all, do y'all like that song is a hit off the album, or y'all like that it's a dope track that Luda promote when he first released the album? Please share. Alright, moving on. Track 11, Ocean Skies featuring Monica. Here we go.
And the winner for the best rap album goes to Ludacris is your year, man.
Go back to my father, who is in critical condition right now. I appreciate your prayers, Mr. Wayne Bridges. I love you.
Rest in peace, Wayne Bridges. You still living through me. Listen. Look, I lost my father to the bottle. I'd hug a man dead like I might not see him tomorrow. Got enough sorrow for a lifetime. Cause when he was living, I'm thinking, how do I get him to listen when he was seldom in his right mind? My early years, I was too young to understand. But I remember the smell of beer and seeing all them empty cans. Waking up, crying in the night, hearing arguments. Hands off my mama, somehow knew he was the cause of it. Got a little older and he got a little worse. Drinking must be his remedy, he got a little curse. Well, tell me what's the cure for a man who misses pops? The beat goes on, but the drinking's got to stop. Tell him he can't drink none of his son's liquor. And tell me, without my father, how am I supposed to manage? He had the biggest heart, but also had that liver damage. So tell me, what's the cure for a man who misses pops? The beat goes on, but the drink has got to stop.
Okay, track 11, Ocean Skies featuring Monica. It's good that he did a song dedicating it to his late father that passed away from drinking. And I say this song is pretty touchy, and I actually can vibe with this song. And you know, this song kind of got like a little rock rap to it. Luda did good with this track, and I really like that he dedicated this song to his late father. And it's good that he put the beautiful singer such as Monica on this track, and she did good with singing the chorus and everything. And you all could tell me, like, we all think of track 11. Does that track make you think about your father, or what type of relationship you had with your father? Because I don't know what to say about mine, though, but the song is dope. All right, moving on. Track 12, Not Long featuring Usher. Here we go, y'all.
Yeah, Usher, baby.
Far from there, and if you follow your heart. tuned them out, they were on another frequency. My mama never minded my decision, and all the bright lights never blinded out my vision. Music was my passion, my first crush. I'm just trying to ride the waves, baby, surf sure. When I'm down, music gets me work good. Plus, it on my shows gets women up for their shirts. What can I say? I'm turned up. I'm on fire. These other rappers is burnt up.
Say track 12, Not Long, featuring Usher. I really feel that beat, and I really like the style that Luda did with this track, him and Usher. You know, Luda was featured on Usher's song, yeah, that came out 18 years ago, and it was the year 2004. It's good that he got to collaborate with Usher on this track, and I gotta say, both of them were tight on this track, and I really feel the flow, and that beat is just dope, and I really like them hardcore lyrics that Luda was spitting, and you all can tell me like what y'all think of track 12 in the comments below. Do y'all feel that track, or y'all just did not really vibe with it that much? Please share. All right, moving on. Track 13, change it to the rap game. Here we go, y'all. I need to quit talking too fast, y'all. My bad.
Everybody wants the fortune and fame. The more things change, the more they stay the same. This industry's like a crap game. Sometimes you gotta charge it to the rap game. Sometimes you gotta charge it to the rap game. Sometimes you gotta charge it to the rap game. This industry's like a crap game. Sometimes you gotta charge it to the rap game. Where do I begin? Well, the industry's shady. Not everybody is your friend. I had to learn that shit the hard way. In and out of focus contracts. And before I was rapping in the hallway. Everyone out for money. Executives out for blood. If you don't keep the music current, then labels will pull the plug. Get it? Hard to admit when shit don't go the way you play. While everybody's on Instagram just fronting like life is grand. Take it back to one of my first tools. Fucking everything moving, thinking movies will never do nothing back to us. Kick them out the hotel, swearing I hit my finer things. Lost a bunch of jewelry from a Rolex to a diamond chain. How in the hell did I get caught slipping? Meanwhile, I'm on my records, licking, talking about these living. May have exaggerated a little bit. You know, fake it till you make it. Every one of us rappers gotta talk a little shit. Yeah, I just smashed some video mixes and some actresses. But brand name pussy don't feel no different on my mattresses. Insecure hoes with breast jobs and foot shots, blaming on us rich niggas sponsoring shit and whatnot. Now guys are just as big as groupies as these women niggas. Till you break up and the bitch wonder where her percentage is. While these regular hoes will try to play that trap game. And now's the time I blame it on the rap game. Everybody wants the fortune and fame. The more things change, the more they stay the same.
Okay, I meant to say charge because I couldn't see the back of the album that good though, but this track is called Charge It to the Rap Game, and I gotta say Luda do speak the truth about how people are in the music industry, especially executive producers. They expect the artists to keep their music going, to keep their ratings up, and if they don't keep their music going, they either suspend their contract or just, you know, pull them out from the label when their music is not flowing or when they haven't made music like in so many years. And I gotta say, Luda do speak the truth about how people are in the music industry, and I actually agree. And this song is dope. I really feel the story that Luda is telling with this track. And you all can tell me like what y'all think of track 13. Do y'all feel what Luda's saying in that track, or y'all think it's true, like how really the music industry are and how women are when it comes to guys who either making a lot of money from like how many records they sell over the years, or records that went worldwide, please share. Alright, moving on, track 14. This How Been My World. This Has Been My World. Here we go. Oh my god, I hate the darkness on the back of the album. Track 14, This Has Been My World. I really like that beat, and I know he sampled the beat from Michael Jackson's 1982 song Human Nature, and I actually like them rhymes, and Luda did good with this track, and I actually vibe with it. And you all can tell me, like, what y'all think of track 14. Is that one of y'all favorite gems? Do y'all like how it turned out? Please share. All right, moving on to the deluxe edition tracks. Track 15, Money featuring Rick Ross. Here we go, y'all. This track 15, Money featuring Rick Ross. I really like the beat, and I really like the rhymes and the story that Luda was telling with this song. And ever since I checked out the deluxe edition of this album, Ludaversal, I say it's better than a previous version. Now only have 14 tracks, but it's like four more tracks added to the deluxe edition, And I gotta say, Ludacris did good with this deluxe edition track, Money. Y'all can tell me what y'all think of it in the comments below. Please share. Alright, moving on. Track 16, Problems, featuring CeeLo Green. Here we go, y'all.
They say, Luna, would you rather have the money or the fame? And I said, he's trying to tell her that it all just depends. Cause every time I make a little more money, I seem to be losing more of my friends. So I give it all up to repeat like over. And they say, Juice, you some fool. I can't trust another motherfucker living in this world, and it's really got me losing my cool. What would you do if you were in my situation? Anything and everyone you ever loved to say you loved up. You drink your pain to the bottom of a bottle in a conjure with how you fucked up. I'm looking for love in all the wrong places. Pop pills, drink, think about a case. Get high, pick a woman, get low, and it's strip club looking for familiar faces. And people know me on a first name basis. But all they ever really want is my cash. Every time I spend a couple $100, and you know that I'ma pay you back my ass. This world's so super fickle. This world done lost my trust. They say, who the fuck you changing? But I really don't give a fuck. What the hell am I supposed to say? What the hell am I supposed to do? I'm hearing that the devil's in the thousand, and I'm hearing that the nigga looks just like you. Like you. Yeah, you know, I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. I don't go straight. And I get down.
Okay, now this song, Problems, featuring CeeLo Green. I really like that beat, and I really like them rhymes that Luda was spitting. But CeeLo Green, he was all right as a feature artist. But the all-tune thing, he needs to just chill out on that, though. But the song is dope, though, other than that. And you walk into me like we y'all think of track 16. Is that one of y'all favorite? Please share. All right, moving on. Track 17, In My Life, featuring John Legend. Here we go, y'all. Track 17, In My Life, featuring John Legend. I really feel that beat, and I really like what Luda's rapping about, like what goes on in his life and what he's capable of. And I say it's a banging deluxe edition track, and I actually feel it. And you walk into him like, what y'all think of track 17? Do y'all feel that track? Do y'all like the rhymes and the hardcore lyrics that Luda was spinning in this track? Please share. All right, moving on. Track 18, final track of the album, Burning Bridges, featuring Jason Aldean. Here we go, y'all.
When all your love is lost,
and I hope you get it right. But not at my expense, I did all I could do. You just took me for granted, you thought I was a fool. When I did everything in my power to help and please it, but I don't know you no more, fuck it, I call that amnesia. Too many emotions I tried to bury, but the higher I climb, the less weight I'm trying to carry. And niggas holding on for dear life, bringing me trauma. But I'm only responsible for my daughter's Kaya karma. Nigga, you the grown man, get yourself together. Forget about the past, now's a better time than ever. Matter of fact, it's time to start making better decisions. So put your fires out and stop burning Christmas bridges.
I gotta say, this song, track 18, Burning Bridges, featuring Jason Aldean. I really think the song is touchy. I really like the beat. It's got like a lot of rock rap to it. And Luda did good this track, though. I don't get how this wasn't a single off the album, but the song is good. It was featured on his EP, but I don't know what the name of the EP was, though. Could have been called Burning Bridges, though, but the song is good. I really vibe with it, and it's got like a lot of rock rap to it. Featuring Pop Melanie. So you walk and tell me, like, we all think of track 18. Is that one of y'all favorite jams? Y'all just didn't really vibe with it that much of how it sound. Please share. All right, well, that's a wrap, everybody. We just went through all 14 tracks plus the four deluxe tracks on this 8th album by Ludacris called Ludaversal. And I gotta say, this album is dope. I really like all the pop, all the lyrics, and I really like all the dopeness and hardcore rapping this album. And Luda did good with this album. You know, this is his recent album that came out 8 years ago, and it was 2015. I gotta say, my favorite tracks on the album is track 1, track 2, track 3, track 4, track 5, and I feel track 8, track 9, and I feel track 10, track 12, track 14, track 15, track 17, and the rest of the songs were good though. But those are my favorite tracks on this album by Ludacris. And you all can tell me, like, we gotta rate this album as one of his best or worst, because me, I get this album 100 stars. And Luda did go with this album, even though a lot of people didn't give him his props in this album debut at number 3 on the charts. But it should debut at number 1, because Luda is a beast and he is a dope legend in the game. And I gotta say, he do be putting out his best music throughout his whole career, and this album is one of his best albums that came out in the late 2015s. Alright, well, this is your boy Jay Bird, aka Mr. Cool Guy, coming to you again with another album review by Ludacris. This is 8th album called Ludaversal. This is the deluxe edition. Feel free to hit that subscribe button, tune to my later videos, check out for my upcoming videos. Thank you all for checking out my previous videos. I love you guys, you all are the best. Peace out. Y'all be good. Take it easy, y'all.